You have a question? You have a question? You got a question on the universe?
Hey.
How are you?
All right, so what's on your mind?
Well, I guess I have two questions. Let me get her. The first one, what's the latest in string theory? Well, I just read Brian.
That counts as 20 questions.
Oh, really?
But, okay. Yeah, but go on.
And then I was reading that there was a lot of development on antimatter engines, and what could that mean as far as getting us farther in space?
All right, string theory, first, they're not there yet. Second, though we have top people working on that problem, but don't hold your breath on that one.
Okay.
They're not there yet, get over it.
All right.
So, antimatter. You know, the stuff is real. It exists. We make it all the time in particle accelerators. And it would be marvelous to have a matter-antimatter engine for spacecraft. There is no development on it. What have you been reading?
Google News.
No development on it whatsoever. The problem is, what are you going to hold the antimatter in?
I don't know.
You got a suitcase to put it? Yeah, it's a magic suitcase.
Magic box.
A magic box. So there's talk of creating some kind of magnetic bottle, because anything antimatter comes in contact with, if it's matter, it annihilates.
Yeah.
So the containment of antimatter is one of the great challenges of the day. And so we can't do it in huge reactors, much less try to do it on a spaceship where the lives of astronauts are at stake. So it's a long way in the future if we ever manage to tame it at all. But it's the most promising form of energy there is. Because as you know, if you bring antimatter in contact with matter, they annihilate entirely. You go from pure matter to pure energy. We know of no more efficient means of producing energy than matter-antimatter annihilation. So just enjoy the science fiction you've been reading, because it ain't going to happen anytime.
All right. Well, thank you very
all right,
much.
Great. Thanks for your question.
Thank you.